this training video from the Penn State Institute for Cyber Science will help you work with our high-performance computing system, the Advanced Cyber Infrastructure, or ICS-ACI for short. This video shows how to submit a job to the ICS-ACI system. We'll start with instructions for submitting a non-interactive job. Then we'll cover how to submit an interactive job. To start, connect to the ACI system with WinSCP or PuTTY. Once you've connected, you'll need to create a job script. To do this, in your remote directory, create a new file. Give it a name. The text editor will open automatically. You'll enter the body of your script in this window. Here, we're creating a PBS script. PBS is a job resource manager. It provides job queuing and execution services in batch cluster environments. We recommend that at the beginning of the script, you include a few extra comments that specify directives to PBS. All of your comments should begin with hashtag PBS. Use the command flag-l, that's flag-l, every time you request resources on the system, like a certain number of nodes or an amount of wall time. Here's how to request parameters for your job. In this example, we're requesting one processor on one node. We're requesting 4 hours of wall time. And we're requesting 1 gigabyte of memory per process. We're also requesting that regular output and terminal output go to the same file. This line places you in the directory from which the job was submitted. Now here's an example of bash script, which runs the program test. The echo command writes each given string to standard output. In other words, it displays the message on screen. This string will display the host name of the node you're running the job on, and the date when the job was started. The command ./ tells the system to look for an executable program in the directory you're currently working in. Here, we've used test as the name of the program. You would use the name of the program you want to execute. Now, save your script. And you can submit the script to PBS for execution. To do this, open a session in PuTTY or Terminal. You'll have to complete two-factor authentication login using Duo Push. Here we're using a Duo passcode. Then enter your password and press Enter. Notice that no characters appear on screen as you type. Here are some commands you can use when submitting a job. Use the command pwd to check what your working directory is. Qsub is the command to submit a script to PBS. By default, Qsub submits the job to the open queue. Please be aware that the open queue has certain limitations. No more than 20 cores for a single job, a maximum of 100 submitted jobs at any one time per user, the maximum wall time is 24 hours, your jobs will only run if resources are available. Back to the qsub command. This command should be followed by your script file name. Here you see that the job script named script.pbs has been submitted to PBS and has been assigned a job ID 547.aci-b.lnx.int.aci.ics.psu.edu. QStat is the command you use to check your job status. It has many useful flags. For example, QStat-F, with the job ID, shows detailed information about the submitted job. Here's the output from the qstat-f command. A job can be in several different states. Queue means the job is queued and waiting to start. R means the job is currently running. E means the job is ending. H means a user hold or system hold has been placed on the job. It won't be eligible to run until the hold is removed. The command qstat u with your user ID shows the status of all PBS jobs submitted by the user. Here we see the output of the qstat u command. This is the queue the job is in. This is the name of the job. This is the memory you requested for the job, the number of gigabytes. This is the wall time you requested. And this is the state of the job. C means completed. This is the elapsed wall time for the job. Here, there's none. And finally, qdel is the command you use to delete a job. This command should be followed by the number from the job ID. As you remember, for our job, it's 547. Now that you know how to submit a non-interactive job to an ICS-ACI cluster, here's how to submit an interactive job. Connect to a cluster with PuTTY for Windows or Terminal for Linux. Submit directives to PBS directly through the command line using the qsub command. The I flag tells qsub this is an interactive job. The syntax of PBS directives is the same as it was in the non-interactive job script, but in this case, you have to omit the PBS tags. Here, we requested a total of one node and one processor per node, PPN equals one. We've requested 10 minutes of wall time, one gigabyte of memory per process. We've also requested that regular output and terminal output go to the same file. Approve your command by pressing Enter. The job is assigned a job ID. The qsub command waits until the job is started. This may take a while, depending on how much the system is loaded. When your job is ready to start, the qsub command gives a prompt on the first compute node assigned to a job. The prompt shows that commands are now being executed on the compute node. Here it's compst240. The command you see here places you in the directory from which the job was submitted. Now you can execute your program. In interactive mode, a program runs by default as a foreground process. Here we see the output which the program MRI new A writes into the standard output as it starts to run. Note that if you put your process in the background using the BG command in Bash shell, you won't be able to check the job status from the compute node from which you're running the job in the interactive mode. Qstat command does not run on the compute node. You have to log into the head node again. To check your interactive job status, choose Duplicate Session from the pop-up menu. A new terminal window will open with an open connection to the same head node you logged into to run your interactive job. You have to go through the login procedure again. And now you can check the status of the interactive job with qstat command. Use the qsub command to notify you that the job is completed and return you to the head node in the terminal window in which the interactive job was submitted. So that's how to submit a job to an ICS-ACI cluster. We've got more training videos on our website, ics.psu.edu.